Hey guys, this is Dr. Matt Najad, and in this video we're going to be talking about when silver fillings should be replaced. This is one of my favorite topics because patients are always asking about this during new patient exams and consultations, and I thought it would be very useful to share the decision-making process in deciding when to replace a silver filling. First off, what is a silver filling? And basically, a silver filling consists of mercury, tin, copper, other trace metals that combine to form an alloy, and there's a lot of controversy regarding this because of the mercury content. In this video, we're going to be covering the problem with silver fillings, the different replacement options, and finally, the advantages of the biomimetic approach. First, we're going to cover the problem with silver fillings. There is so much controversy over silver fillings because of the mercury content, and we all know that mercury is totally unnecessary and totally unsafe for us, but the controversy is regarding how much mercury is safe. And if you ask me, the goal should be to minimize and eliminate mercury wherever we can. The problem though is that the studies show that the mercury that's released from silver fillings is most likely below the threshold of what would actually result in adverse health effects. And currently the FDA and the World Health Organization all believe that these materials are safe. And while I don't have any major issue with those statements, I do think it's important to realize that mercury is toxic, it is avoidable, and that we have better options. Furthermore, silver fillings are not ideal because they do not mimic your natural tooth structure. They're nothing like your enamel and dentin, and they do not adhesively join the tooth together, so they lead to all sorts of problems such as cracks, fractures, recurrent decay, leakage, and even a higher incidence of root canals. So there's better materials, and it's important to realize that silver filling does not meet any of the major goals of an ideal filling material. Fortunately, advancements in dental materials and techniques have given us the ability to more naturally restore your tooth back to its normal strength and function, and we do have better materials that do meet the requirements for an ideal filling material. Speaking of the goals for an ideal filling material, the properties we're looking for are that the filling material is non-toxic, biocompatible, forms a strong seal to prevent leakage, cavities, and decay, has properties similar to natural tooth structure, including your enamel, dentin, and the dentin enamel junction called the DEJ, and that it restores the strength and function of the teeth back to normal. Silver fillings do not adequately restore the properties of natural teeth. They are extremely stiff because they're made of metal, and they do not glue or restore the tooth back together adhesively. And what happens is, as a result, the tooth that has a silver filling develops cracks and fractures because as you function and chew on the tooth, it's bending and flexing more because it does not have its normal structural integrity. When replacing silver fillings, it's important to know the different treatment options. The goal of replacement is to restore the properties of a natural intact tooth. And that brings us to a few different options, but it's important to note that dentistry is not the delivery of a product. It's a service, and that means that whether you get a white filling or an inlay, the quality depends on who provides the restoration, and you can't just compare the results you get with one provider and another, because the number one most important variable in the success of your treatment is the quality and the skill of the person providing the dentistry. With that said, the different replacement options for silver fillings include a white filling known as a composite restoration, a ceramic inlay or onlay for those times when there is more tooth missing or damaged, and then three, a crown, but that's usually avoidable with the biomimetic approach. Let's talk about changing silver fillings to white fillings, otherwise known as composite restorations. There's a lot of different composite restoration material on the market. That means that you have stiff materials, strong materials, quick materials with a lot of different properties. So when you're getting a white filling or a composite restoration, it's important to note that there's so many different options, but this is the ideal replacement option for silver fillings that were small and for teeth that are relatively intact with very little damage to structure. That means tooth structure that is free of decay, cavities, cracks, and fractures. And when there isn't a lot of silver filling and there is a lot of your tooth remaining, then a white filling with a very good approach can be the absolute best restoration and prevent a whole lot of problems. Replacing a silver filling for a crown should always be the last option, but unfortunately, it's a very common practice. The reason why you want to avoid doing a crown is that it involves shaving even more of your healthy remaining tooth structure. So most of the time, if you do have more damage to your existing tooth and you can't do a white filling, then you want to look at an alternative that is still more conservative than a crown. And with the biomimetic approach, there's several different options that will conserve the maximum amount of your remaining tooth structure. When you shave more of the tooth, you result in a lot of future complications, a higher chance of root canals, a higher chance of fractures, and even irritation to the gums and a higher chance of recurrent decay. These are all things that can be avoided, and they're very central to the biomimetic treatment philosophy. Biomimetic dentistry means to mimic the natural tooth. And when you're doing a restoration, it's important for us to try to copy the properties and structure and restore the strength of a natural tooth. The specific protocols, materials, and techniques of biomimetic dentistry give us this ability. And it's not one specific restoration, because biomimetic dentistry can be used for all types of restorations, including fillings, inlays, onlays, and crowns. What makes a restoration biomimetic is the materials and application technique, and also the provider or the dentist's actual approach in performing the procedure. So it's very important to note that most of these inlays, onlays, fillings, and crowns are not performed with a biomimetic approach, and we refer to these as standard restorative techniques. As an example, let's look at a white filling. You can have a standard white filling or a biomimetic white filling, and the difference comes down to the materials, the technique, and even the protocols followed during the procedure. When you do a standard white filling, it's common to perform the filling in a larger bulk. It doesn't usually look like tooth structure. It's a lot flatter. When you see it, you'll notice that the margins aren't as ideal and the shape isn't as ideal. And as a result, what happens is, even though you have the white filling, you're not getting the goal of getting a very strong seal. You're not restoring the properties of the tooth back to the full potential, and it's short of our biomimetic goals. On the other hand, a biomimetic white filling is done in a way that takes more time. So oftentimes there's either more layers or the placement of fiber-based materials, and the combination of protocol and technique, and even the conditions with which the filling is placed, result in a far superior restoration, which has a better seal, better strength, better function, and even better aesthetic outlook. And this makes a biomimetic filling significantly different from a standard white filling that you see all over. You might be asking yourself, why would anyone do a standard white filling? And the answer for that is simple. It takes less time, and in certain practice settings, or even in insurance-based practices, it's impossible to spend the amount of time necessary to do a biomimetic restoration. Like a lot of other things, there's different ranges of qualities when doing a filling. And when you're doing a biomimetic restoration, the fact of the matter is it takes more time, more skill, and more attention to detail. And when you don't do those things, your filling is considered to be standard. And when you do the biomimetic filling and you do all the different steps and protocols, what happens is you're controlling the shrinkage of the filling material. And because you've controlled the shrinkage of the material, you make sure there's no gaps, you ensure that you have the strongest possible adhesion or bonding to the tooth, and the result is superior because of the steps you've taken to ensure this quality. It's not just a yes or no, it's more a specific goal of achieving the final outcome of a biomimetic restoration. Can I change my silver filling to a white filling? The answer to that is absolutely yes, though in a lot of practices, you're told that you need to replace a silver filling with a crown. That's not true for a lot of different silver fillings. Most of the time, you can do either a white filling or a ceramic inlay. The important details to consider are to see how big your silver filling was and also how much of your tooth structure is still healthy and intact. When you have a lot of healthy, intact tooth structure, then it's easy to replace with a composite or white filling. But when you have a lot of damaged tooth structure, then you need to consider something that restores the structural integrity of the tooth, such as a ceramic inlay or an onlay. How much does it cost to replace silver fillings with white fillings? The cost for replacing a silver filling with a white filling depends on what type of restoration and where it's done. You can have a white filling that's done quickly and it would not be biomimetic based on everything we discussed earlier in this video. That could be as cheap as $50 or $80 depending on the size. However, in practices across the nation, the fee for a composite filling can be as high as $1,500 when it's very large and it's essentially an alternative to a crown or an onlay. So the answer to the question is somewhere between $80 and $1,500 depending on the specifics and also depending on the quality with which the restoration is provided. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed and learned a lot about how to replace your silver fillings and all the different treatment options, especially the advantages of a biomimetic approach. For more similar content to this, please make sure to subscribe to my channel.